Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman. The U.S. government has poured hundreds of billions of dollars into the U.S. economy in the wake of the financial crisis. But what steps are being taken to address the crisis on a global scale? On Sunday, the World Bank warned of the first global recession since World War II, with the world economy set to shrink for the first time since the 1940s. The banks also cautioned that the cost of helping poorer nations in crisis would exceed the current financial resources of multilateral lenders. The economic crisis is projected to push around 46 million people into poverty this year. The financial crisis is forcing some to rethink the neoliberal policies widely blamed for the financial collapse. On Monday, British Prime Minister Gordon Brown called for a new international fund to support poorer countries during the global recession. He also acknowledged richer Western nations have often imposed economic policies on poorer countries that they haven't followed themselves.
We will work with the World Bank and our G20 partners to build support for a new fund specifically to help the world's poorest through the downturn. Too often, our responses to past crises have been inadequate or misdirected, promoting economic orthodoxies that we ourselves have not followed and that have condemned the world's poorest to a deepening crisis of poverty.
Brown says he'll raise the issue of a global fund at the next G20 meeting in July. Well, my first guest has been among the leading economists to criticize the neoliberal policies imposed on poor nations, but not followed by the West. Ha-Joon Chang is an economist at the University of Cambridge, specializing in developmental economics. In 2005, he was awarded the Leontief Prize for advancing the frontiers of economic thought. He's author of the books Kicking Away the Ladder, Development Strategy, and Historical Perspective, and his latest is called Bad Samaritans, The Myth of Free Trade and the Secret History of Capitalism. Welcome to Democracy Now! As you come from, well, Gordon Brown's country to this one. First, what is your assessment of the situation right now? Warren Buffett has just said that the economy has gone off a cliff.
Well, I think we are facing the biggest economic crisis since the Great Depression. Now, it probably wouldn't get as bad as the Great Depression, because unlike in the Great Depression, governments are more willing to intervene with deficit spending and nationalizing financial institutions and giving subsidies to industry and so on, whereas in the 1930s, they more kind of adamantly held on to free market doctrines, which late they subsequently abandoned. But I mean, there was a period of time when they just held on to it and lost the opportunity. So I don't think the impact would be as severe as it was, what it was in the 1930s. But yes, I mean, there's no question that this is as big or possibly even bigger crisis than what we saw in 1929.
Can you explain what are neoliberal policies, and then you can critique them?
Yes. Well, basically, the reason why it's called neoliberal is that it's a successor to 19th century classical liberal doctrine. I mean, liberal in American usage usually means kind of left to the center, but in the European usage, liberal means basically big belief in the free market and private ownership and basically rule of money. Now, neoliberals have moderated some of the old liberal beliefs. For example, the old liberals actually thought that democracy was bad for capitalism. Yeah? They thought if you have democracy, poor people will vote and create things like income tax, which they have, but I mean, it actually helped the economy rather than destroy the economy, like the liberals said. So the neoliberals would accept, yes, some degree of progressive income tax. The liberals used to be against, for example, having a central bank. The neoliberals actually liked the central bank pumping money into the economy when things are going wrong. So it has modified the classical liberal doctrine, but neoliberalism still has in its core belief in free market, free trade, deregulated economy, and private ownership.
Do you find it funny that you're saying that Gordon Brown is saying what you have been saying for a while, talking about the hypocrisy of the West? But explain what that is, what the U.S. has done or what the West has done with poorer countries when they're in trouble, and then what we do when we're in trouble.
That's right, yeah. And for example, when the developing countries go into financial crisis like the rich countries are experiencing today, they were told by the IMF and the World Bank and ultimately the rich country governments which control these institutions that they have to cut the spending. Ideally, they should run budget surplus. Yeah? They have to raise interest rate to 30, 50, even 80% in some countries. And basically, they have to tighten the belt. Now that the rich countries have the financial crisis, they have cut interest rate to practically zero. You know, I mean, when South Korea had its financial crisis back in 1997, the IMF insisted that the country runs budget surplus equivalent to 1% of GDP. This year, in the U.S. alone, budget deficit is estimated to be equivalent to something like 12% of GDP. Now, I mean, how do you explain that? I mean, that these policies are, I mean, not good enough for you. I mean, we'll use one set of policy, which we think are the good ones, but you have to use something else. You know, the American writer Gore Vidal, once upon a time, famously said that the American economic system is socialism for the rich and capitalism for the poor. And the international the macroeconomic policies are a bit like that. I mean, it's what I call monetarism for the poor and Keynesianism for the rich. So when the rich countries have the falling demand, they think nothing of boosting it up by printing money and the increasing government spending. The poor countries shouldn't do that. Now, it's only not only the macroeconomic policy where this hypocrisy has a rule. I mean, for example, the rich countries have been telling the developing countries to adopt free trade and told them, look, I mean, all countries in history, probably with the possible exception of Japan, have become richer through free trade. So how do you think that you guys can manage it otherwise? Well, actually, if you look at the British history, American history, you find that today's rich countries used protectionism center left and right when they were developing countries. You know, I mean, for about one century until the Second World War, the United States was actually the most protectionist country in the world. You know, there's something when there when the Pat Buchanan said the free trade is not very American, yeah? Because in its 200 years of history, it has practiced free trade only for about 50 years. Yeah?
We're talking to Ha-Joon Chang, economist at the University of Cambridge, just here from London, going back. Bad Samaritans, The Myth of Free Trade and the Secret History of Capitalism is his book. We'll be back with him in a minute. I've got a feeling for all the people in the world. Some people have all the luck. Some people always get stuck. I've got a feeling for all the people in the world. Don't always do the things I should. In the meantime, I try to be good. I've got a feeling. Money Mark, all the people here on Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman. Our guest is Ha-Joon Chang. He is a world-renowned economist, wrote Bad Samaritans, The Myth of Free Trade and the Secret History of Capitalism. I wanted to ask you about the Obama administration's response to the financial crisis. This is President Obama speaking Friday in Columbus, Ohio.
Now, there were those who argued that our recovery plan was unwise and unnecessary. They opposed the very notion that government has a role in ending the cycle of job loss at the heart of this recession. There are those who believe that all we can do is repeat the very same policies that led us here in the first place. But I also know that this country has never responded to a crisis by sitting on the sidelines and hoping for the best.
President Obama. Your response, Ha-Joon Chang.
Right. Well, I agree with the sentiment, but the people he put in charge of the economy, like Paul Volcker and Larry Summers, I mean, these are people who actually created this problem. You know, the Volcker is, if you like, the godfather of monetarism in this country, and Larry Summers, when he was at the World Bank as the chief economist, and then when he was at the Treasury later, I mean, was going around the world preaching to other countries that they have to